This is Pegasus Launch Control, T-minus 1 hour, 35 minutes, 54 seconds, and counting. Joining us now here in the Mission Director Center is Al Sierra, the Director of the Flight Projects Office for NASA's Launch Services Program. And Al is going to talk to us some about what we've done to get the Pegasus and the NuSTAR ready for the flight. And Al, this really goes back quite some time, because most of the work was done out at California at Vandenberg Air Force Base much earlier this year. I think they got started getting things ready to fly. But Al, we're going to show some video, and if you could talk us through what we're seeing.
Absolutely, George. Okay, so here we're seeing the Pegasus launch vehicle in building 1555, which is located at Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. You see the technicians there getting various parts of the rocket assembled. This rocket is assembled in the horizontal orientation, as opposed to some rockets that are put together in a vertical. Right now, you see they're installing the aft skirt. That is a part of the first stage of the vehicle. As you know, Pegasus is very unique in the sense that it's the only rocket that has wings. The wings are fixed wings. It's a composite and steel material is what it's made of. And that aft skirt there you see is part of the closeout of that aft nozzle. The Pegasus has a total of three stages, first stage, second stage, and third stage. Right there you see they're putting on the avionics structure onto the third stage. That avionics structure holds all the computers and the a tank with gaseous nitrogen, which is used for reaction control, or basically steering that third stage and inserting the spacecraft in the proper orbit. There you see a picture of the first stage, and those items there are the fins. Those fins are installed on the aft end of the first stage. As you see there, it's a crane operation where they will hoist and install those fins. The fins are used to steer that first stage. Unlike other rockets, this nozzle on the first stage is fixed, so it does not move. So it uses these fins to steer the rocket, kind of like an airplane would steer with its ailerons and its vertical stabilizer. The Pegasus will steer with those fins, and those fins are operated with electromechanical actuators. Interesting fact on the Pegasus is that the first stage, I guess the total weight of the rocket is about 51,000 pounds. And that first stage, once it's ignited, will burn approximately 71 seconds. Second stage will burn about 73 seconds. And then that third stage will burn a total of about 68 seconds. As you see here, this is a transporter that they use to transport the Pegasus rocket out to the what we call the hot pad, or where the L-1011 is waiting for it. It's a tight operation there. The wingspan of the Pegasus is about 22 feet in wingspan from left to right, and that opening of the door is basically just they basically have about a foot on each side of clearance. Here you see the NuSTAR spacecraft. It's being processed in a white room, and I guess in a clean room. Basically, is a tented area where we maintain the cleanliness levels to protect the instruments. They're installing the payload fairing on the that basically protects the spacecraft during launch and during the captive carry on the L-1011. This fairing is made of composite material. It's basically two halves that are pulled together and then bolted and attached to the launch vehicle. It uses basically a separation system that's initiated with some linear shape charge explosives. Transport operation starts very early in the morning at about 5 a.m. They start all the preparations to pull the rocket out of the building 1555. As you see there, they're pulling the rocket out. They maintain a purge in the payload fairing while during the transport operation to make sure that the spacecraft is kept in a clean and dry environment. That warning when the spacecraft was when the rocket was pulled out to the hot pad, as you can see, it was a very foggy day, but that it still met the criteria for that operation. So they proceeded with all the mating operation. As you see there, they will be lifting the Pegasus rocket onto the L-1011 or orbital OCA, orbital carrier aircraft. They call it the Stargazer. It uses a system of hooks and umbilicals to connect the rocket to the aircraft. Those umbilicals, we have electrical umbilicals, we have umbilicals to maintain air conditioning inside the payload fairing to maintain the cleanliness of the spacecraft and keep it cool. And the electrical umbilicals provide information on the vehicle health. And there you see the aircraft taking off. This L-1011 is now was there en route to Kwajalein. It did one night stopover at Hawaii Air Force Base at Hickam.
Well, Albert, thank you very much for walking through with us what we've taken to get to this point today, getting the Pegasus ready for flight. Thanks very much.
You're welcome. Thanks.
And we're at launch minus 1 hour, 28 minutes, 48 seconds and counting. This is Pegasus Launch Control.